I'm sure we can all say thank you. Thank God for his amazing power and work in our lives. Thank God for his goodness and for his blessings over us. Thank you that you're able to bring us and give us hope through even the toughest of times, strengthening us for his purpose. Thank God for his great love and care. Thank God for his mercy and grace. Thank God for renewing our spirits. We love God. We need God today and every day of our lives. We give praise and thanks to God. God, you and you alone are worthy. Amen. We're going to ask Tara, if you don't mind, can you open this meeting in prayer? I know this is a surprise to you, but can you open this meeting in prayer if you don't mind?
Loving Heavenly Father, thank you for this time. This is an unexpected opportunity, but thank you, Lord. We know that you're present in every, wherever two or three are gathered, we know, Lord, that you are going to be here. And thank you for this program. Thank you for the organizers. Thank you for all who are attending today, Lord. I pray that you would help each of us to be blessed by this program, Lord. Be with each and every home that's listening to this program, and I pray that you would fill them with your Holy Spirit, Lord. Thank you for this day, and help us to finish on time, and help us to have a good, fruitful, and help us all to live for you. We ask this in your name. Amen.
Thank you, Tara. Next, I'm sure Tara, Tarun, and the Steps girls don't need an introduction. But maybe for some of you who don't know about it, I know my cousin has logged in from Vizag, Sheila. So for your benefit, let me give a small introduction to Tara and the Steps girls. A long time back, I think at the beginning, I wanted Isaac actually to be a speaker for us. And he was supposed to speak for us at the WSCS. Unfortunately, that time they were returning back from Bangalore, and Isaac said, I'm sorry, I can't speak. But years later, we're having Tara and the Step Girls and Tarun with us here. Isaac and Tara had no kids of their own, but the Lord laid upon Tara's heart to get two kids, Tarun and Sitara. And that was not enough. The Lord, I'm sure, told Tara, no, don't be happy with this. You've got to get me more children. And she became a mother of Israel, truly. And she has these beautiful Step Girls with her. And I am witness to the fact that I've been to their house, and those girls are so well looked after, so much of love, and they've got so much of love for Tara. My God, she just has to step in the room and they're all over her. Such beautiful children, brought up so well. You will hear them sing. You're so blessed to have them minister to us in song today. And I must say, thank you, Tarun, you're a young boy, for taking this time out and being with us ladies, old ladies at that. Thank you, son. God bless you for all that you're doing. And I know in the introduction I said stepping into his dad's shoes. His dad's shoes are sure not easy to step into and to fill. But Tarun is there, and Sitara are there with your mom, helping and building their lives all over again. So I'm handing over the meeting now to Tara.
Thank you, WSCS, for inviting us. I want to especially thank Anita and Lillian and for believing in us and for having us here today. Even though your term is ending, I pray that the Lord would use you, if not in WSCS, but elsewhere too. So we have a few songs lined up for you. The girls are going to sing. This is our first time we are singing without Isaac having to back us up. I know it's really hard. It's been hard living without Isaac. And it was hard when he died, but it's harder when, you know, to live without him, because he has too big a shoe to fill. And we're all missing that void. I mean, it's so empty right now. I want to thank our church for being such a support to us. We haven't had the courage to enter EMC, but this is our first ever attempt to have anything to do with the Methodist, actually. So thank you, Anita and Lillian, for making it possible. The girls have three songs lined up, and the first song we have is Here We Are to Worship. Here I Am to Worship, and let's all sing it together and worship the Lord. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Tara. Now we'll spotlight the girls.
Yeah.
Sing my dead before, oh my soul. Please join as we sing this song together.
Thank you, dear step girls. I think we need Loud applause for you. Praise God that there was no connectivity issues. Praise God. Such beautiful singing. Lord, we need you. Truly, we need you. Thank you, girls. I know we didn't give them much time to practice. I know we didn't give you all. We hardly gave you all, I think, 4 or 5 days. But how well you have sung the glory of God. May God's bless. We are blessed to have you here today with us. All blessings are ours. But God bless each one of you as you walk this life. And thank God for such lovely family you have and the family which was given to you. Praise God. Thank you, girls. We love you so much. Thank you so much. Now we're going to have Tarun speak to us.
Am I audible?
Hello? Yes, you are audible, Tarun, loud and clear.
Okay, thank you, Auntie. Thank you, girls, for leading us in praise and worship. My dad used to have a joke. Him and my mom cannot sing. And so that's why he blessed Sitara and me with the ability to sing. But clearly, these girls sing 50,000 times better than I ever could. So thank you, girls, for the wonderful song. I wanted to start by thanking Anita Auntie and Lillian Auntie for giving the girls this opportunity and myself this opportunity to attend this event. Thank you for thinking of us. And I wanted to start as all people try to, you know, with a joke, start something light and then go deep into the situation. So my theme for today was given to me was stepping into my father's shoes. I don't know if this counts as a joke, but I'm a measly 9.5 in bata. In our classic bata shoe, I am a 9.5, whereas my father is a 12.5. So when I say that it is a big shoe to fill, I could wear it as a hat and it still wouldn't fit. Okay, now that some people are laughing, mm-hmm. Okay, let's begin. So a lot of you knew my dad, and June 12th, 2020 was a big blow for our family. It was the day that we lost Dr. Isaac Manogaram to COVID-19. Dad passed away doing what he loved. He was doing social work, giving as he always did. And a lot of you know him as, you know, this fun and jovial person. And I got to know him as the strict father, but also as the fun-loving dad. And I'm sure all the girls and Sitara can attest to that. So I wanted to prepare something, but I was thinking, you know what, if I prepare something, it'll become very fake. It won't be original. So if you got to say it in the moment, so please excuse me if I stutter or if, you know, I say the same thing again and again. But this last year has been a challenge. Learning. It has been a huge learning curve. If anything, it'll be that. My dad was a jack of all trades and a master at all trades. My dad was our everything. And lots of people wanted to know what's happening with us, what's happening, how are we, what's happening. So thank you so much, everyone who's a part of EMC. I feel like that goes without saying that I need to thank everyone who thought of us and prayed for dad and for our family, who continue to pray. And so where do I begin? With the last year being the difficult year that it was, it's just been a rat race of sorts, trying to fill in dad's shoes, as you said. Single-handedly, it is not possible, but our family has banded together and we have tried our level best to do that. If not me, I'd like to say that my mother is filling in his shoes the most. And God has given us the strength to keep moving, keep carrying on, keep pushing and trying to finish the good work that dad started. Mom has been trying her best, and all that I like to say is that mom is the Supreme Court, if I'm the High Court. And so I am just here to back her up, and so is Sitara and all of us. We all just try to be pillars of support for mom during this time, and it has been hard. We've been trying to, you know, grow and develop steps and dad's ministry, but it has been hard without him, because no one can do what my dad did. My dad was all over the place when it comes, whether be it in ministry, be it at EMC, be it preaching, he was all over the place doing his best. So when people ask us for an update, I think I'd rather go step by step. So in regards to the steps girls, I'm proud to say that most of them are back in school. The girls are in Jesse Moses. Lots of them are in their 9th and 10th, all, and a few of them are in their lower grades, and they're all happily going back to school. Do pray for Thresa and Bharti. They are our first 12th standard girls about to finish this year. And next year is off to college. So how exciting is that? And in regards to Dad's Christian arts and music business and all of that, I'd like to say that I am currently taking over it. If anything, as I said, I am not the Supreme Court. I am the High Court. So the boss is Tara Manogaram, but then there's Tarun in the corner. And so we are trying to revamp it and restart Dad's Christian art business, and trying to come up with new designs and new things for the Christian community to, you know, decorate your homes with and stuff like that. In regards to our family, though it has been hard, the Lord has been a good shepherd. Over anything, He has given us the strength to keep going. And even when the times get tough, I purely do believe that it was because of the strength of God that we were able to get through those tough times. And I can honestly say that it's my dad sitting there watching over us, giving us wisdom and the guidance that we needed. I'm pretty sure there's nothing else left to say. The kids are doing well. By God's grace, we are all keeping safe. And I feel I also need to explain what Mom meant by this is the first thing that we're doing in connection with EMC. As you all know, Dad was heavily invested in EMC, be it being my cushion on the pews where pastor would be preaching and I'd just sanjify on him and sleep, or be it on the pulpit himself preaching at all of us. He was heavily invested in EMC, on the pastoral committee. Everyone knows this. He was involved with the youth and all over the place. But it's been hard for us to go back. It's been hard for us to, you know, there's so many memories at EMC. And so that is why I think it's taken us so long to connect with our EMC family again. But nonetheless, we are so grateful and thankful to everyone who prayed for us, who stood by us during these hard times. And yeah, that's pretty much it. So once again, thank you, aunties, for giving us this chance to be here today. And yeah, take care and God bless.
Thank you, Tarun. Thank you so much. I'm sure your dad's real proud of you. You're a chip of the old block. I mean, your dad's messages used to be, I mean, first his voice, right? His voice would reverberate across the whole church, would be loud. And he would pep his talk with a lot of fun, humor, and yet the message would go across. So we are so happy that that you have ministered to us. Thank you so much, Tara, especially you. I know how difficult this must be, but praise God, you all have come for our session today. Thank you so much, Tarun. God bless you. God guide each one of you. Like you said, the two girls are going to do their 12th, definitely in our prayers. And I remember your dad reaching out to us, asking us if we can mentor some of the girls. Now, ladies, I don't know how many of you are here, but you have seen the girls. And I think as ladies, we need to reach out to them and be there for them in this time of need and this time of difficulty. So I'm sure we can do our bit to help them. But thank you so much, Tarun. Thank you, Tara. And thank you, the step girls. We love you all so much. God bless you. Thank you. Okay, next we'll have Lillian introduce our special speaker for the day. Okay, I'm sorry. I missed this. We have two special songs sung to us by the step girls. Now, they were a little bit worried that that the connectivity would be a problem, so they recorded this song for us. So let's hear these two special songs sung by the girls.
Thank you. It's been
The time is now. Thank you, dear girls. The song was so beautiful. Both songs are so beautiful. Minister to us. Thank you. Pleasure is all ours. Next, we're going to have Lillian introduce the speaker, as Dr. Sujatha Prasad.
Good evening and a warm welcome to all our WSCS ladies once again. Of course, we were blessed with the stepgirls and our budding speaker, Tarun Manogaram. A big thank you, Tara and Tara, for allowing your stepgirls to minister to us. You are very much in our prayers, Tara. God bless and be with you. This evening, we have a wonderful speaker in our midst to share the word. Sujatha was from Emmanuel Methodist Church. It was here that she was confirmed and also taught at the Sunday school. She was then known as Sujatha Chinnan. Some of y'all may remember her mother, Mrs. Chinnan, a very God-fearing lady. After studies, she got married to this wonderful, soft-spoken, godly man, Mr. Prasad Umen, from the St. Andrew's Kirk Church, Egmore. She became Mrs. Sujatha Prasad. Ever since then, she has been worshiping at the Kirk Church and attending the evening service at the Ananaga Methodist Church. She is blessed with two daughters, Zena and Zaina, both married, and they are blessed with one grandson. Sujatha is also a BSF group leader. Dr. Sujatha Prasad retired as the Chief General Manager of the Reserve Bank of India. What a post that was. I am so blessed that she got married to my cousin, Prasad Umen. Once again, we welcome Dr. Sujatha Elizabeth Prasad in our midst. And what a beautiful topic she has spoken. She's going to talk about finishing strong for us young ladies at heart. Over to Sujatha.
Thank you very much, Lillian. It's just like homecoming. Some of you I've seen and known also. I was so happy when I saw Dolly. As soon as I entered in, she's there. And there are many others whom I know who are of my age. And it's nice that the topic is finishing strong. Then we've just witnessed a person who has finished strong. And we have an example, live example. And it's good to be able to speak about this topic. Before that, shall we pray? Lord Jesus, we thank you for this time and we pray, Lord Jesus, that you will speak to us. Help us to know your heart and your will for us, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I don't know what you thought of when you heard of this topic, finishing strong. I think it's not wrong if you can unmute and speak also. Anybody would like to just think of what it means to finish strong?
run the race till the end, looking up to Jesus.
Yeah, run the race and till the end. That's also a nice way to say. Anybody else want to add something more?
We start with a bang and don't have to end with a whimper.
Okay,
we start
loudly.
With a bang. We start with a bang.
Okay,
and don't
okay.
have to end with a whimper.
Okay. All right. I'll just share the screen and we'll just see about some people who have run the race well and who have finished strong. Okay.
Sujatha, I made you co-host, so yeah.
Yeah, yeah, I saw. Thank you. I wonder if you know this person. Have you seen this person's photo at least sometimes? This is a person, John Stephen Anquari. He was in the 1968 Olympic marathon. He is from Tanzania and he had to play in the Olympics that was held in Mexico. But when he started the race, it's a 42-kilometer race. When he started the race halfway through, he fell down, he hurt his knee, and he had to get it bandaged. But he continued to run. So when the race was finished and the prizes were distributed and the entire crew was getting ready to go home, suddenly they found one person was still running the race. And so they came back and found that he was running the race and he was late by 1 hour from the person who won the race. What persistence. Mm. And then they asked him, why did you run this race like this when you were hurt and you knew you will never get a prize? What he said was very nice. He said, Tanzania didn't send me 5,000 kilometers to participate in this race, just to start the race. They sent me to finish the race. God has sent all of us to finish the race, not to just start the race. So today we'll just see there are many ways by which we can think about finishing the race. But I just want to take just two parameters. One, that we will be in the faith when we leave the world and we will leave a legacy. Just now we heard of a person who left a great legacy. And I was wondering whether we could think of some people in the Bible who have left great legacies. Anybody would like to share? You can unmute and share also. Anybody would like to share of someone in the Bible whom you think has finished very strong?
Saint Paul.
Paul. Joseph. Okay.
Paul.
Paul. Yes.
Deborah.
Okay. There are many people we could think of who finished strong. In fact, Jesus said it is finished on the cross. You know, he has
finished.
Pardon? It is finished. He said it is finished because he has finished the task for which God had ordained for him. Paul said that he has fought the race and he's won the prize. Stephen said at the time of his death, he said, I see heavens open and I can see Jesus standing at the cross, at the right hand of God, getting ready to welcome Stephen. But we may not be like Stephen, neither like Paul. Can I finish strong? I'll show you some pictures. I think we can identify these people and then we will see how they finish strong. Can you identify these people?
Uh,
First one is Elizabeth.
Yes. How did she finish strong? Anybody would like to say what is the legacy she left behind?
John the Baptist for sure.
Great. Okay. The legacy was a child. But I would say that her legacy was being a blessed woman, blessing others. She was blessing Mary. She said, blessed are you that you didn't doubt God. Blessed are you because you said yes. What about Mary? Did she leave a legacy?
Yeah, Mary also.
Yeah, she also left a great legacy. A legacy of a surrendered life.
Yeah.
I am the Lord's handmaid. Let's look at the second picture. The old lady at the back. Did she leave a legacy? Who is she?
Anna.
Very good. So Anna has also left a legacy. What was her legacy?
She stayed in the temple for
84 years. She stayed.
And prayed.
Okay. I thought her legacy was joy in witnessing.
Oh, yes.
After she saw the little baby, yeah, she went around saying, the Messiah is born. And there was joy. So that is a legacy all of us can have. The joy of witnessing. The next couple.
John the Baptist, mother and father.
Okay. Yeah. Can you guess somebody else who was also born?
Abraham and Sarah.
What is the legacy that Sarah left?
She was known as the mother of nations.
Okay. The legacy I thought she left was obedience. You know, it says in 1 Peter 3:6.
Yeah, yeah.
She was very obedient. So she has left that legacy. The last picture. We should guess by the
Adam
dress.
Adam and Eve.
Yeah, we look at Eve only because it's a women's fellowship. So I thought of only the ladies. Okay, let's look at Eve. Did she leave any legacy? We always blame her, no? For all, everything that is happening in the world, we blame Adam and Eve. But did she leave any legacy? Remember when they sinned, God told them that your seed will fight, will kill, will win over Satan. And when her first child was born in Genesis chapter 4, verse 1, she said, with God's help, I brought forth a son. No, she was thinking that this son would be the seed that will crush the head of the serpent. So she left the legacy of hope. So these are all old people. Young people are there in our midst. They must be thinking what young people like legacy can leave. Who is the first lady here?
Dorcas.
Lydia.
Lydia, what did she, what was the legacy she left, Lydia?
She did a lot for the poor.
Opened the house for prayer.
Lydia sold her costly clothes. Garments. Scarlet garments.
Okay. Lydia, actually, the Bible, if you look in Acts chapter 16, we see how God opened Lydia's heart.
Right.
She was able to accept the Lord as her savior. Immediately, she opened her home.
Oh, yeah.
So she opened her home. See, we may not have many talents. At least we could open our home. We can leave that legacy of having an open home. Okay, then we have our Dorcas. And we all know what legacy she left behind.
It's for the poor.
Yeah, making garments. No, the Bible calls her that she's the only woman disciple who's called a disciple. And she left the legacy of good works. And who's the other lady there?
Priscilla.
Priscilla making her tents.
Tent makers. What legacy
did she leave?
They discipled many people.
She discipled. She mentored many people. That's the greatest legacy. I think all of us can do that. Anita was asking about mentoring our stepchildren. So here also we have this lady who was mentoring Apollos, and we see how Apollos became a great person because of her mentoring. And the last slide, last person. I don't know whether we can recognize her.
Ruth?
No, no. The one who adulteress. Yeah. The other
was it?
Adultery. Who was caught in adultery, yeah? That lady, yeah?
No.
Somebody from New Testament, I think.
No, actually, I don't know. It's actually this picture of Deborah.
Judging.
You see, as a leader, she was able to manage the entire army. We may think of now women in the armed forces, but here was a judge who really did judge. It even in those days, leading an army. So we
behind
see
the palm tree.
So all of us, she was a judge and the thing. So all of us can be leave a legacy. So when we think of finishing strong, as I said before, two things: one is being in the faith, and the other is leaving a legacy.
Legacy.
So to be in the faith, we should always develop a deep knowledge of God. Psalm 71 is supposed to be the psalm for that is from youth to the old. So there we see how the psalmist says we must develop a deep knowledge of God, and we do it by studying the word of God. And we, if you look in this book, in Psalm 71, it gives us so many attributes of God. You know, here few of them I just listed. God is my refuge. God is my savior. God is faithful. God gives strength and power. God is my deliverer. God is the God of all comfort. Every day when we read the word of God, we should always look to find out what I know more of God. The more we know God, the more we'll be able to live a life of faith. And this is a great thing that we should develop as we spend time with the word of God. Let's every day find out one attribute of God, something of God, more of God. The more we know God, the more we'd like to be like God. The second way by which we will have to develop a life of faith is by developing godly habits. You know, I don't know what your habits are, but this psalm says, Psalm 71 says, you develop three habits: habit of trust, habit of hope, and habit of praise. As we grow older, we have the habit of grumbling. We have the habit of finding fault. But God is telling us, you have these, develop these habits. In fact, I think we know this quote, which we always hear many people say: in happy moments, praise God. In difficult moments, seek God. In quiet moments, trust God. In every moment, thank God. The Bible tells us to have an attitude of praise. So if we want to live in the faith, we should not only develop deep knowledge about God, we should also develop godly attitudes of hope, trust, and praise. And thirdly, the Psalm 71 says we should have a lifestyle of ministry. You may think, what ministry can I do? As a woman, I'm at home. Even in lockdown period, can I do something for God? And here it gives, in Psalm 71, it gives us three ways by which we can have a ministry wherever we are. One is about telling others. Especially it says, at least you proclaim God's might to the next generation. You may be having children at home, you may be having grandchildren, we may be having neighbors. Will we be able to tell, to proclaim? And it also says, my lips will shout for joy, sing praises to God. So Psalm 71 tells you, develop a lifestyle of ministry, no matter how old you are or how young you are. God wants us to have this life of faith. And this life of faith comes through knowing God and developing godly attributes, and also living a lifestyle of ministry. I thought we'd look at a very a person in the Bible whom we may think has never left any legacy.
because she's overshadowed by her daughter-in-law. Can you guess who's this lady in the Bible?
Naomi.
Yeah. Naomi. Did Naomi leave a legacy? That's what we are going to see. And for that, I took the verse from 1 Timothy 4:7. It says, how to leave a legacy? One is to fight a good fight. Second is to keep the faith. And third is to finish the race. So did Naomi fight the good fight? Did she keep the faith? Did she finish the race? So this is what we will see. And we'll, if you have the Bibles, you can look at the book of Ruth. Otherwise, we can just see the slides. We'll get all the stories in the slides. She fought the good fight. We know where she was living at the beginning of the story. She was living in the land of Moab. But she was looking for God moments. I don't know whether she was reading the newspaper or what was there. But she was looking for God moments. And the Bible tells us that when she heard that God had visited Bethlehem, she immediately knew that's the place where she should be. So God, the way to fight the good fight is looking for God moments in our lives. She found God's moment as soon as she heard that God had visited the clan. And immediately she left that clan and she was coming back. And she told her children, her daughters-in-law, you just leave me and go. May God show mercy to you. May God help you to find the rest in your husband's house. So she says she fought the good fight. Not only did she recognize God's presence in that land to which she's going to go, she wanted to bless others also with that. So God moments help us to bless others. And here we find that God in his mercy, when we look to God, he'll give us godly friends. He'll give us people to be with us. He'll help us not to be lonely. And so Naomi got Ruth. And at the end of that book, we hear all the women saying, you found a daughter-in-law who is more better than seven sons. So you see how God provided. When we look to God, when there are God moments in our life and we seize those moments, God gives us godly people to be with us. We no longer will become lonely. And also God provided a kinsman redeemer in Boaz. So to fight the good fight, the first thing is to look for God moments. Seize the moments and ask God to use those moments. Secondly, to leave a good legacy, we must keep the faith. Now we must look for people moments. Not only should we look for God moments, we must also look for people. And here we see how Naomi says to her daughter-in-law, should I not find a home for you? Should I not see that you are happy in your husband's house? What a beautiful mother-in-law. She is looking for the interests of others, her daughter-in-law. And she found in Boaz the kinsman redeemer. And we see how she says, once he knows that you are he is a kinsman redeemer, he will not rest till he solves this problem. And therefore, she kept the faith. She looked at the people. She found people moments to help her, to bring God the glory. No, we can share, as we learned in the beginning, that we can proclaim God's word. We can look for ways we can help people also to come into the faith. So not only she held fast to the faith, she kept the faith. And lastly is the time for finishing the race. This is actually the applause time that we can clap our hands and say, what a big, good race you won. Did Naomi win the race? Of course she did. In fact, when the baby was born, they didn't say it is Ruth's baby. They said it is Naomi's baby. They said Naomi has got a son and Naomi has got a kinsman redeemer. And the beautiful thing is that Jesus came in the line of Naomi's little son, Obed, Jesse,
David.
Yeah, so this is just what I wanted to share. Maybe all of us could, we can remember this verse well. I have fought the good fight, kept the faith, and I have finished the race. Shall we pray? Lord Jesus, we thank you for teaching us from your word. And we pray, Lord Jesus, that you will help us always to finish strong. Help our faith to be a faith that is grounded in you, Lord Jesus, and that is very infectious, that others will see Christ, Lord. We pray that you will open our eyes to see God moments in our lives and to be people oriented and to share your good news, Lord. We thank you for this time. We thank you for all of us who've come here. And we pray, Lord Jesus, that you will help us to finish the race, to win the prize which you have kept for us. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Thank you.
Thank you, dear sir, Dr. Sujatha Prasad. Thank you so much. I'm going to call upon Suganti Prisla just to say a few words.
Yes. On behalf of the WSCS, I thank Dr. Sujatha Prasad, retired Chief General Manager, RBI, for her interesting and informative speech on finishing strong. Thank you, Doctor, for giving us many examples from the Bible to explain to us that how important it is to finish the race. You have given us advice about developing a deep knowledge of God and to develop godly habits and to develop a lifestyle of ministry. And you also emphasized on keeping the faith that would help us to finish the race. It was a pleasure listening to you, and I'm sure all of us will follow the points you've given us today. I once again thank you for bringing us this important message. Our prayers and wishes to you. Thank you.
Thank you, Suganti Akka. Thank you so much. And now we're going to celebrate the birthday. We're coming to the end. So now we're going to celebrate the birthday babies. Let's have the birthday song. While we are thinking, ask all of you to put on your put your cameras on, please. Mute your mics and put your cameras on.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, happy birthday. Happy birthday to you.
Angela Ka and Geeta Theoplis Ka, happy birthday to y'all. Do you all want to say something? Do you want to sing a song? Do you want to say something? And then we'll have Lillian give us the bouquet.
Thank you, everyone. God has been good to me. I praise and thank God for the years that have rolled by.
Thank you, Angela. I don't know if Geeta Theoplis Ka is there. Now we'll ask Lillian to give us a bouquet. 1 minute, Lillian, we will spotlight you. Yeah, Lillian, you can give us a bouquet.
Bouquet. Wow. I'm beautiful. Tulips. Thank beautiful you. Tulips.
Thank you so much, Lillian. Thank you. Do we have Pastor Lucas with us here? He said he would be here. Pastor Lucas, would you like to say something? Are you here? Malin, is Pastor here?
No, Anita. I don't think so.
Okay, fine. Okay, now we're going to have just 1 minute. I'm going to put a slide on. We want to welcome the new committee.
Oh my gosh.
Being here, and today is the last, September 15th was the last day for the old committee. And we want to welcome Jayaka as the president, Jebasiri Akka as the vice president, Viola, Parmeshwari, Vasanti Akka and Biju Akka, new committee. God's blessing. You know, in the past you have done a great job. We know with God's blessing and His will continue what has been done so far. We will continue. Thank you for being here for us and blessing us, and you will be a blessing to everybody who's going to be as you're taking over. Next, I would like to thank God for giving us this opportunity for being the committee to help serve Him the last 2.5 years. It's only God's grace. So thank you, church, for giving us this opportunity. Thanking the pastors, Pastor Simeon, Pastor James, especially our WSCS pastor, Pastor Lucas. Thank you for your prayers. Thank you for being with us. Thank you for your guidance. And thank you for helping us for today. WSCS sisters, what do I say? I'm a loss of words. Every time we met, every time we had a gathering, every time we spoke, it has been such a blessing because y'all don't think old, y'all think so young. Whatever we asked y'all, y'all did. Thank you for the love, thank you for the support, thank you for the prayers. I know how each one of y'all called us up, spoke to us, offered the help to us. God bless each one of you to the point of your need. The EMC is definitely a blessed WSCS. Like recently when we raised money for the vaccine, open heart you gave to me. It's so wonderful your gave, and it's not the first time, you'll always do it. Thank you so much. God bless you. Love you, Lord. Love you, Lord. I'm going to thank Eva. Eva, you opened up your house always for us. Thank you for taking care of the prayers also. So well, every Friday you planned and made the prayers. Bless you, Eva. You truly are a blessing to us. Malati, my go-to lady, my technical savvy person. Thank you for all that you do without even asking, Malati. God bless you, Malati. Malar, always in the background. If I remember, Malar, thanks to the omelette, you and I would be the only ones always standing there making it. Thank you for the work you do, you know, which you don't even tell, Malar. Like even the aprons, how you helped us. I remember making the fried ice cream, Malar, for the youth. Thank you, Malar. God bless you. And I would like to thank Biju Akka, who's always there to support Lillian in whatever we did. Biju Akka, you're such a blessing. God bless you, dear. I would like to thank the committee. Pramila Akka, thank you, Pramila Akka. It is your meticulous planning of the finance of the shelters. Thank you so much. Sujanti Akka, always there with a smile to help us. Thank you to you, Akka. Thank you for the blessing. Nicola, all those coffee shops, thank you, Nicola. You have been such a blessing to us, Nicola, with all your plans, all your ideas and support. Lillian, what do I say? My dear cousin Lillian, I must say. Thank you for making all my crazy ideas come true, Lillian. I know I gave you a tough time, and today she warned me. After today, you can't call me 11:30, 12 in the night asking me, telling me things and asking me for help. So Lillian, I promise I will call you still. Whatever time. And last but not least, I must say a huge thank you to my husband Sam, to Shial and Shobil, without whom I would not have been able to run all this. Thanks, my children. I love them so much. And Sam, I love Sam too, okay? And I'm ending with this. And I want to say thank you all for giving us this opportunity. I know the new committee, we kept you on hold for a very long time. Sorry, it was not intentional. But now it's your turn. God's blessing on you all. And I know you'll do it wonderfully. Thank you so much. Now we're going to have the closing prayer. And I'm going to invite Nicola to do the closing prayer. 1 minute, Nicola. Let me spotlight you.
Finishing.
Nicola, 1 second, Nicola. Yeah, Nicola.
Okay. Let's pray.
Our loving Heavenly Father, we thank you, Master, for speaking to us and making this WSCS so meaningful. We thank you, Master, for enabling the steps children to lead us in praise and worship, which was such a blessing, Master. We thank you, Master. Thank you for the wonderful way you have led Tara, Tarun, Sitara to continue this ministry which Isaac started, Master. We just continue to uphold them. Pray that you'd continue to be their pillar of strength. And may you always be a great strength to the steps ministry, Master. Master, this time we thank you for the wonderful way you enabled the speaker to bring the word, Master. We thank you for Mrs. Sujatha Prasad. Thank you for the wonderful way how we need to finish strong, Master. She led us through wonderful insights into godly people, Master. We thank you, Master. Thank you for all the examples we see in the Bible, Master. We thank you, Master. We pray that you'd continue to be with us. Help us to develop godly habits, Master, and enable us to have the trust, faith, and praise and hope in you, Master. We pray that you'd enable us to what we learn be rooted in our word, be shown in our lifestyle, Master. Enable us to apply into what we learn, into our doing, Master. We thank you for the wonderful way we were able to hear and hear your word. We pray that you'd continue to bless Mrs. Sujatha Prasad, Master. We want to thank you for the wonderful way you enabled the old committee, I mean the committee which is outgoing. We pray for Anita's leadership. We thank you, Master, for even during this lockdowns, you have enabled her, and of course, Lilian Akka, Pramila, Suganti, and for enabling all of us to lead in whatever capacity, Master. We thank you for your strength. Very specially, we thank you for the tech savvy that enabling Anita to do many things, even with quizzes, a camp, outreach was possible. We thank you for all those opportunities, Master. We know that your hand, your guidance was there in all these 2.5 years, Master. We continue to pray that you'd bless the outgoing team, that you'd continue to lead them into doing your work in whatever way, the capacity, Master. We continue to pray for the new team who's taking over. We pray for Jaya. We thank you for the leadership. We thank you for the team. We pray that you'd continue to bless this team as they take this forward, Master. We pray that WCS ministry would truly be a place where godly women will be strengthened, that we would always be the light which will reflect you in everything we do, Master. We thank you. We continue to uphold WCS into thy loving hands. We thank you for this time. We ask all these things in your precious name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Nicola. If the outgoing committee of Pramila, Suganti, Nicola, Lilian, if you'd like to say a few words, this is your time to say anything. I know Nicola prayed, but yeah, if Pramila, I know your message that you came in late. If you'd like to say anything, now's the time to say. Or like you know, the weddings, they say, no, if not forever, hold your peace.
I'll just say something.
Yeah, Pramila. One second. Let me spotlight you, Akka, 1 minute. Yeah, carry on.
I think maybe all of us are in the committee, but most of the work Anita only did. I know we were only helping her out, but she has because she is much younger than all of us, many of us, she has a lot of ideas, new ideas. And every time she used to introduce something, we used to think whether it will be possible in WSCS. But somehow she'll make it. She'll not make us do many things, but somehow with her help of her family, she did many things. I really appreciate her for the effort she took to do all this. And also this camp, planning of the camp and everything. She wanted everything to be perfect, not just for the sake of it, but to do it all perfectly. And I think God will bless her in all this for whatever effort she took for WSCS. And in the future, I'm sure God is going to give her a better assignment to do, to show her skills more and develop her like the, whatever God talents God has given to use it for His glory. I wish her all success in the religious work, not in the others, other things only, but also for the for her service to the church.
Thank you, Pramila.
And also Lillian for supporting her, Lanita and everything. Lillian was her right hand, and maybe all of us did a little, but Lanita and Lillian did a good job. We must really appreciate their efforts.
Thank you, Pramilaka. As a committee, I think we did, all of us did. Thank you so much. But yes.
Anita, I want to talk a little bit.
One minute. Yeah, I can talk. I'll spotlight you.
Okay.
Mohanaka Yuli, right?
Yeah. So on behalf of all the sisters in WSCS, I want to thank Anita and team. They have meticulously done a lot of work. So Anita is young, and as she is an HR manager, she plans so well and made each and every WSCS meeting and program so wonderful and so lovely. And I know Lillian also supported her. Even though Anita is so busy, behind the scenes, Lillian did everything, but the brain, main brain and main planning was made by Anita. And I see that through these 2.5 years, many young people, they have joined in our WSCS team. When we started the Zoom online, and more than 50-51 people joined in our WSCS meeting, and many are interested to join in our WSCS fellowship. Especially, she has attracted many young people. So now we have the new team where Parameshwari is young, Viola is young, and all are some middle age. They are all interested. I sincerely thank Anita and team for the meticulous work during this season. And I wish that in future also, whatever God places there, she will do the ministry. And we also request you, Lillian and Anita, to give your support to the new team. And also I welcome Jaya and team. Also, we know that Jaya has already done 4 years service as the president of WSCS. And now she has taken up also the CRC president. So her job ministry is also great. She has to put a lot of effort and put a lot of time to minister to the, all these ministries. So I say that all the WSCS members, sisters, we will support you and help you in different capacities. Whenever you reach out, we are there. And we welcome the new team, Anita and team. Jaya and team. We know that Jaya is the first president. She took over to the one night stay for camp, and we are expecting many more camps like Andaman camp.
Yeah.
Maybe we can go to Sri Lanka or somewhere. So once this pandemic situation become over, and when everything become normal, we are expecting that Jaya will take us to different places, and we will have wonderful time together as sisters in Christ. Thank you all.
Thank you, Akka. Thank you so much. One last request. Can we have all your videos on so, so Malathi, our official
Anita, can I tell something, Anita?
Sure, Akka. 1 minute. Let us spotlight you. 1 minute, Akka.
No need of spotlighting me. But I'm just wanting to thank Anita, Lillian, and the team. Oh, my gosh. What have I don't have words to say. You have done a wonderful job. You know, in spite of this lockdown, we didn't miss anything. We enjoyed every program of yours. You are an excellent HR, and we need your help. Please, you and your family, your both the boys, we need your help. And we thank you, Lillian, and the others very, very much. You have really enriched us with your program, and we ask you to help us also. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Akka. Thank you so much for
that. Yes, Anita, very true. We enjoyed all the fellowship, plus we enjoyed the WSCS prayer, which you have started.
Yes.
And the quiz. Okay, so everything, we really, so we thank and praise God for you, Lillian, and all the committee members for your really, you know, like encouraging fellowships we had.
Thank you, Akka. You mentored Anita, us well, Akka.
Anita, can I say a few, two or three sentences? Can I do it?
Yes, please? Eva. 1 minute, Eva. Yeah. Sure. Okay. Yeah, Eva.
Okay, you're spotlighting me. Okay, fine. Anita, I just want to say we thank you and Lillian from the very depths of our heart for all that you've done for our WSCS. Such unique programs. God has given you that creativity and the way you led all of us and did so many special things, unique things that we have never done before. And it's been exciting. Every WSCS has been exciting. And we have all learned things, you know, I mean, the people you brought, the speakers whom you brought into our WSCS meetings. And we have all learned many things. And I believe that it's a kind of, you know, getting gathering momentum. I believe God will continue to work in and through the new group as well. And it's just because you all are not now in the committee doesn't mean that you're not there as well. We continue to work well, we give our ideas and inspire one another and spur one another.
We won't leave them, Eva. We won't leave them.
Yeah. We spur one another to good works. And so we will all pray for you all. We'll continue to pray for you all as we fulfill the vision of our church. As we all mature together as women, and as we also reach out to other women and into other places, I believe that we will keep this vision as well. We'll continue to keep this vision alive. Thank you so much. And thank God you. Bless you, and also the new team, Jaya and team, God bless you all and guide you all.
Thank you.
Anita, we missed the dinner, no, which you have started after the every I meeting.
Know,
no? That really, we, because of this lockdown, no, we could
have. But one thing which Pramila Ka and all never said was, I mean, they're very kind enough not to have said it, and only the committee knows, but Pramila Ka said that I'm a perfect, I do things like pakka. But pity the committee, you know, because the first committee were the ones who had to execute everything. I would have the ideas. I know I drove them crazy because I would want only the best. Okay, let's do it the best. Starting off with shopping for our saris. I mean, they would know how we had to trudge shop after shop. And Nicola, I never did this anytime like this. I remember Nicola saying that. But the committee has done so much. I will fail in my duty if I say the committee was not behind me all the way. I put them through a tough time, my poor committee, but love them so much for being there for me. Thank you so much.
Enjoy the Christmas dinner. I'll never forget about that dinner. The moonlight and the lighting and all that. Wow, that was lovely.
The barbecue.
Barbecue.
Yeah,
barbecue.
That's what I'm saying, the barbecue.
And the dancing also.
Okay.
Polar
top. I know. Yeah. We have the cameras on, everybody, so we can take the photograph and photograph. Margaret Akka, can you just pray and do the benediction, Akka?
Our Heavenly Father, we want to thank you and praise you for the beautiful time you have given us. And this, you have blessed our fellowship. Lord, we want to thank you and praise you for the committee which is leaving and for the committee which is taking over. Lord, we pray that you will bless each one of them. And we pray that you will bless each one of us to be a witness for you and finish our life for the glory of God and leave a legacy for our family to follow. Lord, we pray that you will bless each one of us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. நம்முடைய கர்த்தராகிய இயேசு கிறிஸ்துவின் கிருபையும் பிதாவாகிய தேவனுடைய அன்பும் பரிசுத்த ஆவியானவருடைய அன்யோன்ய ஐக்கியமும் நம் அனைவரோடும் நம்முடைய பிள்ளைகளோடும் இன்றும் என்றும் சதா காலங்களிலும் இருப்பதாக. ஆமென்.
ஆமென். Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits.
Amen.